If you want to increase your Google Pay speed to 99 in both mobile and desktop within the next 5 minutes, then this video is for you. Because in this video, I'm going to show you how you can achieve this result with just one click. As you can see, this is the post which I'm referring, and these are the scores. Let me show you the live demo in order to prove you that you can achieve these results. So this is a sample demo post which I am referring. I haven't published this post yet. It is having a lot of images. So let me publish it. Once I publish it, let me copy the link and also let us view this page. This is how the page looks like without any optimization. And in order to prove you that there are no optimization done, let me take you to my dashboard and then to the plugin section. As you can see, there are no catchy plugins and short pixel image optimizer is also deactivated. Let us test the pay speed without any optimization. It will take some time for the page to load because there are lots of criteria that the page speed is verifying. So hold on a minute. As you can see, without optimization, I'm having 93 score. And the reason is that this is a very brand new demo website. And the theme which I'm using is Astra theme, which is also light speed. So I've activated the short pixel. Let's go to the bulk image optimization section. And then let's bulk image everything that is present in this website. So let's get started. It is going to take some time. A considerable amount of time depending upon your number of pages and images available. So let me pause it for a minute. So now as you can see, it is almost done. You cannot leave this tab while the optimization is being done. So bulk optimization has been finished. I got the congratulation message. Let's take you to the library section. You will find that the images has been optimized. Let's see the list version. As you can see, all my images have been optimized. Now once the images have been optimized, this is pre-optimization data. And now let me show you the website, the particular post. Just wait on. See, this is the post. It looks exactly like the one without optimization. So there has not been any visual degradation in the page. Now let me check the page speed after optimization. Again, it is going to take some time, so hold on. There are lots of parameters that Google analyzes in order to tell you the page speed. As you can see, I have achieved 99 in both desktop and mobile. This is the pre-optimization. It was 93. It is also a very good score. But after just one click, I have achieved 99. And you can also achieve this by following through this video. So stay with me and let's optimize our website. Before you do any optimization, I will suggest you keep a backup of your WordPress for safety and also do a pre-optimization test in order to verify whether your website was optimized or not. Images are necessary for every website because they are engaging and helps to increase the reader's retention, and that will improve your bounce rate. They are also the reason why your website is slow, and hence image optimization is required. You can obviously manually optimize it, which I used to do, but it's time consuming. The advantage of image optimization is that it will improve your website page speed, it will reduce the disk space required, it will save bandwidth, and once bandwidth is saved, it will save your money. I have tried many optimization tools and every time I return to ShortPixel. Let me show you the website. This is how the website looks like. The reason I like ShortPixel is that they are simple and lightweight. They offer lots of customization. They can do bulk optimization as I have already shown you with just one click. And they can also optimize images outside the library. They can also optimize PDF. They can convert your images to WebP. And all of them can be done automatically, automatic resization. Now the free version will let you only optimize 100 images per month. But if you use my referral link, which is present in the description also, you will receive 100 images extra per month. So in total, you will have 200 images per month plus 100 one-time credit. So you can use my referral link in order to get these 100 images. Now, the plugin offers three types of compression. The lossy compression is default. Most websites will need lossy compression. Glossy is required for photography based websites where there are lots of images and you need quality over image size. Lossless will keep your images as it is. Now, WebP is the next generation image format, and like PNG, it supports transparency, and ShotPixel can convert your images to WebP automatically. ShotPixel allow you to keep original unoptimized images so that you can re-optimize them later on and also restore the original file. In case you don't want to keep the original, you can also turn off the backup in order to save your disk space. Now, there is another plugin available by ShotPixel, which is their adaptive ShotPixels. Now, it uses their own CDN, but since I have my own CDN, Bunny CDN, which is very effective, I do not use this. Now, if you want to know more about Bunny CDN and how you can get the 14-day free trial plus a $10 of free credit with no credit card required, then you need to watch my 11th video from WordPress tutorial for beginners in the channel Blog Monk. Over here, I have explained you about Bunny CDN. Now let's get back to our topic. Once you install through my link, you will get the 100 images credit. Then you will also have the API through which you can connect to your WordPress. Plugin has four tabs. Let me show you them. Go to settings, then go to ShotPixel. Over here, you will have the four tabs: general, advanced, Cloudflare API and statistics. WordPress resources are their recommendations. Now, these are the tabs. I'm going to explain each of them in the next section. In order to get the free 100 images per month credit, take the link below and paste it in your browser. You have to provide your email ID. So copy the name of the email ID which you are going to regularly use and paste it over there. You can read the terms and condition and privacy policy, and then you can sign up. That's it. You will get your API key. Kindly keep this API key safe. You need the API key in order to connect your ShotPixel plugin with the dashboard. Now, as you can see, they have 100 images per month credit, but because you have used my link, you will get 200 images per month credit. There are other plans available. They also have one-time plans. Buy them only if you have too many images in your website. I don't, so I am not using them. In their web dashboard, you have many functions available. You can change your email, you can change your password, you can change your API. As you can see, though it is 100 credit per month initially, but because you have used my referral, so you are getting 200 images per month. The month quota will reset every month, and it does not matter when you have installed. So preferably install this plugin at the start of the month. They will provide you a confirmation email that your account has been set up. On that confirmation email, you will find your API key. You will also have a link through which you can directly access your ShotPixel dashboard. You can compress the image either on the WordPress dashboard or in ShotPixel web interface. It depends upon you where you want to do it. I will suggest you use ShotPixel plugin if you have images already present in your WordPress or you upload many images in your blog posts. You can also change your current password. Just type in your current password, then type the new password and retype the new password and change it. It will easily get changed. In order to install the plugin, go to plugin, add new, and then type ShotPixel. ShotPixel. And type enter. You will get that there are two plugins available. One is ShotPixel Optimizer, another is ShotPixel Adaptive Image. Now, ShotPixel Adaptive Image, they use the ShotPixel CDN in order to generate the image. But I already have Bunny CDN, so I do not need it. I am using ShotPixel Image Optimizer. If you want to know how you can increase the website speed by using Bunny CDN, watch 11th video on WordPress tutorial in my playlist. You will also find that link in the description and in the comment section. After the plugin gets installed, kindly activate the plugin. It might take some time in order to activate. Once you have activated, you will need the API key which was generated for you. You have two options to activate, either provide the email ID and then request a key, or if you already have the key, kindly copy and paste it. The API key is present in your mail ID or in the web interface. So copy the API key and then go to your plugin section and paste it. Once you have pasted it, you have to validate it. If your API key is correct, then you will get the success message that your API key is valid. They have three types of compression algorithm. Selecting the options here will only affect the newly uploaded images. The images which are already present in your WordPress, for them you need bulk optimization, which we will see later on. You should include thumbnails to compress so that it reduces page size and increases website speed. You must keep the image backup and remove the EXIF data. In the advanced section, you can convert PNG images to JPEG. The short pixel algorithm will only compress the image if the JPEG image is of smaller size than the PNG images. You can also convert all your images into the WebP version. But remember, it is going to get deducted from your credit images per month. I use Lightspeed plugin, which converts the images into WebP version, so I do not use ShortPixel to do it. So it depends upon you what you want to do. Also, if you take this option, in that case, ShortPixel is going to deliver the WebP version to your audience, which is going to drastically improve the website speed. Again, I use Lightspeed plugin in order to do this function for me, so I am not going to select this. If you have any doubt, you can comment below. I will try to solve your doubt. Read these warning messages so that you understand what you are doing. So kindly go through them. If you have any doubt, you can comment below. And since I am using Lightspeed plugin in order to do this function for me, so I do not select this. Now let me untick them. Themes and plugins have images which are not listed in the gallery. Use ShortPixel this option in order to compress them. You can also compress the PDF in ShortPixel. So tick them on. Also, you can automatically optimize the image added by the user. You can exclude thumbnail sizes also. We will see them later on. If you use Cloudflare CDN, then use the Zone ID and Global API. I do not use, so I am not going to enter any data. Over here, you have ShortPixel WordPress resource recommendations, so you can check them. So these were the general settings available. You can go through them individually and see what suits you. Once you are comfortable, hit the save changes or save and go to bulk process. So it will take you to this dashboard where you can bulk optimize all the images which are already present in your website. So they are going to show how much credit are going to be used. Once you have done the bulk optimization, you have to keep this particular tab open as long as the optimization is taking place. If you close this tab, in that case the optimization will stop and you have to start it again. So you can do whatever you want to do with the website in the meantime, but you have to keep this particular tab on. Now it is going to show you how it is optimizing. If you have too many images, in that case it is going to take considerable amount of time. So as you can see, it is going to show you the original image and the optimized image and how much percentage it has optimized. Once all the images are compressed, you will get the confirmation in the form of congratulations. You can cross-check the settings, restart the optimization, bulk delete the data, or bulk restore. You can also see the summary of the optimization done. How much quota has been used and the space saved is also mentioned. You can go to stats and see the informations in detail. What is the percentage of compression done? Also the bandwidth saved, which is very important because bandwidth saved is money saved. So you can check these datas. How many images are remaining? You can also cross-check them. If you want, you can empty the backup data also. Go to the media library and over there you will see the data. You have to change it to the list format in order to see all the information. in the thumbnail format, you cannot see them. So click it over here to go to the list view. Once you are on the list view, you can see how your short pixel has optimized. If you click it, you can re-optimize the image in the various formats, lossless, lossy, or you can also backup the images. So please, you go through these settings and see how much it has compressed. It can also compress your PDF, as I have shown you. PNG also has been compressed, as you can see over here. So if you click compare, you can see how both the compressed image and the non-compressed image look. So one is the original image, another is the compressed image. If you are satisfied with the compression, then keep it as it is, or you can recompress it depending upon your requirement. You can also restore from the backup. Lossy is recommended because it is going to reduce the image to the lowest size. Select glossy if you want to balance between compression and image quality. Lossless will keep the image as it is, but it will increase the image size. So select your compression algorithm as per your choice.